Long time. Last
I
met
know.
You was for Mughal-e Azam.
I know.
And everything seems to have changed. We have not only gone back in time, it seems we're in the dark ages now. Isolation.
I know. There seems to be no past. And we are waiting for Godot.
Yeah, exactly. I so agree with you. So how it's been like creatively a very lucrative time for you, from film, theater, it's now animation.
I mean, it's just that, you know, I was at home. I've been doing other things. I've been writing, reading, catching up on many things. But I've been engaged with the Population Foundation of India for a very long time. In fact, a large part of my life is connected with the work that they do. So they wanted to do this communication, around COVID-19 and around Corona. And they wanted to find an interesting way of doing it. So then we realized that there was no way that we could actually shoot anybody. So animation could be a very good sort of, route to go through that. And I had never done it before. So it was a great challenge. And we found a way of communicating the message in an interesting way.
How has the transition been? TV, stage, animation? You've done all aspects.
I think it's not a transition. You could be working in, there are some principles which are same for all of them. It's just that how quickly you're able to adapt. I think is the adaptability is the issue. For me, it's not a transition. It's all is the same.
And then you have Kavi Potliwala. You know, Hasya Kavi. I remember as children used to love listening to Hasya Kavis. It's
correct.
Been a while. I think you all sat down and heard Hasya Kavi or went to Hasya Kavi Kamelans.
Yeah. You see, what I thought was that there's so much of this information coming on COVID that it's also, there's a bit of a kind of a boredom that's coming. The moment you hear somebody's giving you a message, you're switching off. So I thought it would be a very good idea is to get the audience in, either through a Potliwala, Hasya Kavi. He's great to look at. He's a very lovable character. And the lines that he speaks are wonderful. And yet at the end, you also get a message. So I thought that's a good way of sort of accessing the audience without sort of, boring them to death. Because I think this whole messaging now needs to have a different way of communication rather than this in-the-face people coming and giving you all these kind of gyans and moral lessons and so on and so forth. I think it's now not working.
Absolutely. All those fake WhatsApps and those long bhashans, nobody is interested. Everyone has their own theories.
Yeah. So I think we thought, and also it had to be short. There's one thing I realized, that animation really pushed me in that direction, that how to communicate something important, get the message across. It should be very entertaining and should be done in a very short span of time. So all the Potliwalas are not more than 30 seconds. And most of the adalat, this Corona ki adalat, is only 90 seconds. So you are able to get the audience interest level high when you are short and more precise.
Do you also feel the narratives now going to be changing in the times to come? How do you think storytelling is going to change now?
You see, actually, it's very difficult because storytelling is more intrinsically linked to the medium. So I think that if you're going to be telling more stories on the OTT platforms, because we really don't know when cinema halls are going to open up, right? So if the OTT platforms is where you're going to do, then of course the narratives are going to change quite a lot. There would also be new stories that will come in. I feel it's going to be very strong on content. It will not just be driven by stars and so on and so forth, because now it's a small sort of screen on which you're operating. So I think what I see that times to come, the content is going to be driving the stories and not necessarily just the stars if you're going to be an OTT platform. The moment the size of the screen becomes bigger, you need a star.
Which is true. But have you also realized these days also with OTT, I'm not giving a generalized view on everything. Just the initial starts, a lot of people, it seems to be a little star driven. Who's in it? Who's headlining it? Have you noticed that thoda sa wo aa raha hai?
Wo to aayega hi na, Pooja. We always like stars. You can't take that away. Okay. But then you see that there are OTT platforms that are creating their own stars. Like recently I watched Patal Lok, and I think it's one of the finest thing that we had on OTT platform. It really is perhaps to me the best thing on OTT platform, because the ones that I saw before that, some of them I couldn't handle it because either it had too much of abusive content without any reason, or they were explicit sex, or it was it was in a way very hollow, trying to fill it up with explicit sort of, you know, dialogues and sex and all those kind of things, but inside somewhere very hollow. Whereas Patal Lok is very rich. It's very rich, it's very layered. And I think that's the kind of stuff that I really look forward to now watching on Indian OTT platforms. Yeah.
And also with COVID, also with budgets being slashed, I mean, stars will have to take a pay cut. Do you also feel those opulent films are now going to be a thing of the past for some time, and we'll have more intimate stories now being told, you know?
I would say that as soon as we are out of it, as soon as you have a vaccine, as soon as you have a treatment, you go back to normal life, you need stories to forget life. Because see, there are two kinds of stories. One that confronts life, and the other is that wants you to forget life. So forget life is where the mainstream entertainment comes in. And surely for a long time, it's going to happen. People would like to forget all that they've gone through. Those stories will never go. Larger than life, fantasies, stories and love world designed for your pleasure, they will come back, but they will come back only once the screen is big. And once your cinema halls are open, then it will. But the economics, I don't know, because I think whether people will have that kind of money to spend on multiplexes and so on and so forth. So those are going to be new negotiations in terms of price cuts and pay cuts and so on and so forth. Yeah.
What about theatre, sir? I mean, you've gave us this lovely Mughlaism, and you know, you're working on your next. What about theatre? What do you think? Theatre also has taken a beating.
Well, a huge beating. In fact, I did one more after that. I did something called Ronak and Jesse. That's yes. A Romeo and Juliet.
Yes.
I think that theatre is worrying me a lot, because I've been very involved with Prithvi Theatre. So we've been on constant conversation, me and Kunal, with how do we go forward? Because that's going to be perhaps one of the last things that will open up. And that's where it's very worrying, honestly speaking, because I don't see it opening very soon. And even if it opens, it's going to be, you know, with all the social distancing and so on and so forth. Theatre cannot work like that, you know. You need a full audience. You need all of them together at the same place. And I think that worries me a lot, honestly. Yeah, I don't know when we are going to open up in theatre.
And also, sir, recently we've just seen the passing away of a young talent who could not... Yeah. not, you know, come to terms with the pressures and whatever his journey. He was a bright star. Do you think also the industry now should be a little sensitized towards mental health and the pressure that it puts on stars? You've been part of the industry for so long. You know, sometimes, I mean, no one would have thought that this bright mind, so strong will, would succumb to, you know.
Yeah, no, his loss has really baffled everyone. I know that he started in theatre. He learned from Nadira Babbar Ek Jud Group, which means that he was at Prithvi Theatre. So I've just seen him not much. I saw him in one of the meetings and so on and so forth. But looking at the kind of a talent that he was in the choir boy, he was, his loss has really baffled us. As long as mental health is concerned, mental health is something that in India, there seems to be a stigma. There's one of the problems is we need to deal with this, because anytime you try to go out and say, I need help, people think that there's something wrong with you. Mental health is not something wrong with you. It's like any other disease or physical disease that you could have, or, you know, you need to go and take help. I do feel that mental health, not just for the film industry, I think for every industry, it is going to be a huge challenge. And we have neglected it for a very long time. We've neglected it for a very long time. And I think this needs to now also be incorporated in everything else that we do with health.
So also it's brought out the outsider versus insider debate. I mean, everyone's journey is their own. I'm not taking it away from anybody on that. So what do you think about that for somebody who has been in the industry and carved a niche for himself through your own trials and tribulations?
See, I have never been that much in the mainstream film industry as such. I've been primarily in theater. It would be, you know, I think it's a presumption on my part to actually make any comments on that, what's an outsider or an insider. I've actually had no problem with, interestingly, there are lots of big guys who have worked with me in theatre and so on and so forth. So I haven't really felt anything of that sort. Maybe if I was doing more of the mainstream cinema, and if I was in that space, maybe I would have perhaps experience. On the other hand, I do believe that in this industry or any industry, if you're good, you will finally... succeed. There is no doubt about it. But this insider outsider, I think, is not just limited to Hindi film industry or the film industry. It happens to be everywhere. This is part of a journey. And I think in film industry, of course, the pressures can be much more than any other industry, because
exactly.
we need to be validated all the time. We need that validation all the time. So I suppose the pressure is more, but then such is life, Pooja. It is, yeah.
I so agree. I think it's a validation, that insecurity that comes in, the likes being seen all the time. That puts
all
pressure.
The time. Yeah, I mean, you know, like for example, with the social media, that is really putting a lot of pressure. You are figuring who you are every few hours. I mean, if you send a post, you need to understand how many people like you, dislike you. It's so neurotic. I mean, when I watch people constantly engaging and sending out a picture here or a comment here or something like that, and then if they don't get the number of likes and dislikes that they want, so they get very upset about it. So you are actually doing that constantly the whole day around. You are trying to get validation every hourly basis. Now that's not healthy. That's not healthy.
So, I mean, any plans to make a film? I mean, your movies like, Mark Babas, I mean, we all remember those. Any plans to make a film?
Yeah, now that I'm sitting in here, I have, I'm working on a couple of film scripts. I think the next thing would be that I would like to make a film now. I've done lots of plays. The last one I did was also a big musical, not as big as Mohleyasam, but again, and it did well. So they will all come back and they will perform as and when. But right now I'm very charged about doing films. So I've done two films, Gandhi, My Father, and Dekh Tamasha Dekh. But now I'm feeling that I must make more films. And at least there are two or three scripts that are in the making. So once we are out of this, I will try and get my films realized.
Any plans to explore the digital space? Well, that seems to be the in thing.
I don't know. At the moment, I don't know. I'm not. I haven't thought about it. I basically have been thinking only in theater and cinema. Now I also think of scale. So for a small screen or a small stage, right now looks to me slightly, limiting. So it's just that sure. I feel that I want to do a film on a big scale and maybe, on a big screen. So digital, I have not thought about it, yeah.
And lastly, since you've done a Corona Ki Adalat, what has been your biggest takeaway from this lockdown? This is the first time, like the industry, everything, all industries, it's a global lockdown. First time ever.
Yeah, I think it's one of the times that it's extremely difficult to actually process what's happening around you. One of the things that has told you is that there are the privileged and there are not the privileged. And while it has brought out some of the worst things that you can see, particularly amongst the middle class, their reaction to the things around the people who aren't as fortunate as you are, has left me very saddened, honestly speaking. In the initial stages, I was far more sad than anything else, because you were helpless, you couldn't do anything, you can't help people. Because normal times, you can at least go out and do things. Now you're so tied up that you can't do things for anybody. And I think that that is to me one of the pains that I'm carrying during this lockdown.
Anyway, sir, lovely chatting with you. Hope to see you in person soon. And
yes,
welcome Corona Ki Adalat and Kabhi Potliwala, and we'll entertain ourselves watching that. Kuch to hasne ko chahiye.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye, sir. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.